Whenever I use the subdivision surface modifier, it can mercilessly smooth everything out, meaning I have to go in and add a bunch of support loops to get my desired result. However, there's a cool modifier that can help us with this, called the edge split modifier, which would mean we wouldn't need to bother with as many support loops for a lot of different types of objects. To demonstrate this, I'm going to press Shift A, and then under mesh, I'm just going to choose cylinder. Then I'm going to left click my blue spanner to go into modifier properties, go to add modifier, then under generate, and then I'm going to choose subdivision surface. You can see right now it's totally messed up my cylinder as I explained it would, and if we were to fix this we would need to add some supporting loops. Now let's show what this edge split modifier will do. So I'll press add modifier, then under generate I'm going to choose edge split. Right now nothing will change, and that's because it's on the bottom here. So first I'm going to left click this arrow here and then choose move to first. You can see straight away now we're getting more geometry on our cylinder here, but we still got the smoothness. And this will work as I'm modeling as well. So I'll press tab to go into edit mode, and I'm going to press 3 on the keyboard to go into face slide. And I'm going to select this top face here. Then I'll press I to inset, and I'm going to press E to extrude. I'm just going to left click this monitor button here on the edge split to turn it off. You'll see this is what we would usually be dealing with. But with the edge split on, you can see we can get the smoothing in between everything, while still we can get the smoothing we were looking for, and separate everything out based on this angle. Once you're finished modeling, you can of course apply all these modifiers as well, and you would need to go through a couple of extra steps which I'll go over later because of the nature of the edge split modifier, as essentially what it's doing is it's separating these collection of faces based on the angle which is set by this edge angle here. Let's talk a little bit more about these settings. First of all, edge angle. Essentially what this means is you can see between this face and these collection of faces here, the degree difference inward is about 90 degrees. So like from this face here to this face here, it's roughly 90 degrees. And you can test this because if I set my edge angle to 90, you'll see it will go back to smoothing everything out again. But if I change it down to 89, you can see that's when it's first going to start separating things properly. Usually an edge angle of 30 or 60 will usually suffice for most cases. You can see if I turn off this checkbox, it's just going to remove that option for us. Next up, we have sharp edges. When enabled, edges will be split if they are marked as sharp. So for example, I'll turn off my edge angle for now, and if I press tab to go into edit mode and press 2 on the keyboard, I'm just going to press alt left click on this edge loop here, and I'm going to right click and then choose mark sharp. You'll see now that because we have the sharp edges setting on, any sharp edges we mark will be split like that. If I turn this off, you can see that the effect will no longer be present. You can of course use both of these effects simultaneously. So if I wanted to maybe make this edge here split, then I could mark it sharp. I mentioned earlier that there might be an extra step you need to do once you apply your modifiers, if that's what you need to do, maybe for exporting it to another software for example. I'm going to press tab to go back to object mode. I also, while I'm at it, I might shade smooth. So I'm just going to right click and then choose shade smooth. You'll notice because everything's split, we actually don't need to use the shade auto smooth this time. But of course, you could still right click and choose shade auto smooth as well, if you'd prefer. This edge angle works very similarly to how the angle and shade auto smooth works. I'm going to start off by left clicking this arrow here and pressing apply. And then I'll left click the arrow of the subdivision and press apply. When I press tab to go into edit mode, one of the first things you'll notice is if I press L, rather than selecting everything, you'll notice that everything has been segmented. And this will maybe give you a better idea of what edge split is actually doing. It's separating out these things into components, so when the subdivision is applied, in our case, it applies it to these individual elements, which stops us from getting the smoothing out in the areas we don't want. But if you want to merge everything back together, thankfully, it's very simple. All I need to do is press A, and then M to open the merge menu. Then I can choose by distance. By distance will just allow you to merge vertices based over a distance calculated by meters. You can see the default is a really, really small number, and since all these vertices are overlapping, that is all we need. And to be honest, if you increase this number too much, you might accidentally merge vertices you don't want to. So I highly recommend you leave it at the default here. If you can't see this menu, it's probably hidden like this, so you can just left click it to open it. Do keep in mind when you click away, this menu would disappear. And yeah, that just about covers it. I thought I'd quickly go over the edge split modifier and how it can be useful to you. It's a very old modifier, but still one which I find myself using from time to time. So definitely a good one to add to your Blender knowledge tool belt. If you want to learn more about modifiers, I have a full series on Blender modifiers in depth. So make sure to check that out if you want to learn more here. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.